नेक्स्ट टॉपिक सिंपल हार्मोनिक मोशन. ए बॉडी इज सेड टू बी इन सिंपल हार्मोनिक मोशन इफ इट मूव्स टू एंड फ्रो अलोंग इट्स मीन पोजिशन सच दैट एट एनी पॉइंट इट्स एक्सेलरेशन इज ऑलवेज प्रोपोर्शनल टू इट्स डिस्प्लेसमेंट इन मैग्नीट्यूड बट अपोजिट इन डायरेक्शन एंड it directed always towards the mean position. If a is the acceleration of the body at any given displacement y from the mean position, we can write acceleration is always directly proportional to displacement in magnitude opposite in direction. So here minus indicate opposite direction. Condition for simple harmonic motion. Motion of the particle must be periodic. Particle must move to and fro about a mean position. Acceleration of the particle is directly proportional to displacement in magnitude and opposite in direction. So A is proportional to minus y. Acceleration of the particle must be always directed towards the mean position. Acceleration of the particle is always directed towards the mean position. These are the conditions for simple harmonic motions. Let us see some examples. In a spring block system, here it is mean position. When we apply force on the block, so that is F external force, the block is oscillating about mean position. Here the block is oscillating about mean position means the motion of the block repeat after a certain interval of time. So it is a periodic motion, and the motion of the block is to and fro about the mean position. So this condition is also satisfied. Here when we apply force on the block is oscillating about mean position. So here restoring forces are generated to keep the body at mean position. So that is towards the mean position. According to Newton's second law, F is equal to ma. So that is equal to ma. If displacement is increase, the restoring force is also increase. So a restoring force is increase means what? Acceleration of the block is also increase. So displacement is increase, acceleration of the block is also increase. So here the acceleration of the block is directly proportional to displacement and both are in opposite direction. So see here, displacement is towards the left side, right side direction, acceleration is towards the left side direction. So this condition is satisfied. Here restoring force is always directed towards the mean position to keep the body at mean position. So a restoring force is towards the mean position means what? Acceleration of the block is also directed towards the mean position. So this condition is also satisfied. So finally the block execute simple harmonic motion. See another example in a simple pendulum. The block is oscillating. So here it is mean position. When we applied force on the block, so that is F external force, the block is oscillating about mean position. So here block is oscillating means the motion of the block is repeated after a certain interval of time. So it is a periodic motion. The motion of the bob is to and fro about a mean position. So this condition is also satisfied. And here when we applied force on the bob, restoring forces are generated to keep the body at mean position. So that is towards the mean position. So here restoring force, F restoring, that is equal, according to Newton's second law, F is equal ma. If displacement is increased, so here it is displacement. If we increase displacement, the restoring forces also increases. Here restoring forces increases means what? Acceleration of the bob also increases. So finally, if displacement is increases, acceleration of the block also increases. So acceleration of the block is directly proportional to displacement in magnitude and both are in opposite direction. So here displacement is towards right side direction, acceleration of the blob is towards the left side direction. So acceleration is directly proportional to displacement in magnitude and it is in opposite direction. So this condition also satisfied. So here acceleration, so restoring force is always towards the mean position to keep the body at mean position. So here restoring force is directed towards the mean position means what? Acceleration is also directed towards the mean position. So this condition is also satisfied. So here bob execute simple harmonic motion. See, at extreme position displacement is maximum. So here x is maximum, here x is maximum. At extreme position velocity becomes zero. So velocity is zero. At mean position displacement is zero, velocity is maximum. So here at extreme position velocity is zero, kinetic energy is half mv square, here v is zero, kinetic energy is zero, so here also kinetic energy is zero, but potential energy is maximum, here also potential energy is maximum. At mean position displacement is zero, displacement is zero means what? Potential energy is zero, kinetic energy is maximum. So when block is at extreme, it have only potential energy, kinetic energy is zero. When it reaches to mean position, kinetic energy increases, potential energy is decreases. So here it have only potential energy, kinetic energy is zero. When the block reached to mean position, the potential energy is decreases, kinetic energy is increases. So at mean position, potential energy is zero, kinetic energy is maximum. When block reached to extreme position, potential energy is increases, kinetic energy is decreases. So at extreme position, potential energy is converted into kinetic energy. So at extreme position, potential energy is exist, kinetic energy is zero. So here kinetic energy is converted into potential energy, but total energy remains constant. See, in simple pendulum, at extreme position displacement is maximum. So here x is maximum, here also x is maximum. Velocity becomes zero. At mean position, displacement is zero, velocity is maximum. So at extreme position, velocity is zero. Means kinetic energy is equal to half mv square. Here v is zero, so kinetic energy is zero. So here also kinetic energy is zero. So here displacement is maximum, so potential energy is maximum. Potential energy is maximum. At mean position, displacement is zero, so potential energy is zero, kinetic energy is maximum. So at extreme position, it have only potential energy. At mean position, it have only kinetic energy. So when Bob reached to extreme position to mean position, potential energy is converted into kinetic energy. So when Bob reached to here, so it is kinetic energy is converted into potential energy. So total energy remains constant. So here at extreme position, kinetic energy is zero, potential energy is maximum. When Bob is reached to mean position, so it have only kinetic energy, or kinetic energy is maximum, potential energy is zero. So when Bob is reached at extreme position, it have only potential energy, kinetic energy becomes zero. But total energy remains same at every part. Consider a particle P oscillating back and forth about the origin of an x-axis between the limits plus A to minus A. So here it is positive x-axis, here it is negative x-axis. So your particle execute simple harmonic motion. So that is oscillate about mean position. If the particle execute simple harmonic motion, the displacement variable, so here x of t is equal to a cos omega t plus pi. Your displacement variable is sinusoidal function of time. So here what is sinusoidal function? The function must be in sine or cosine. So if particle executes simple harmonic motion, the displacement variable must be in sine or cosine function. So here A is amplitude of SHM, simple harmonic motion. So that is nothing but the maximum displacement of the particle. Here omega t plus pi. Omega t plus pi is phase. Here phase is nothing but the state of the particle. So that is position, speed. If t is equal to 0, here t is equal to 0, the angle pi is known as phase constant. Now I am taking the position of particle execute simple harmonic motion at discrete value of time. Here time period is t. So I am taking the position of the particle at time t is equal to 0, t is equal to t by 4, t is equal to t by 2, t is equal to 3t by 4, t is equal to t, and t is equal to 5t by 4. So here at time t is equal to 0, here it is origin. It is plus A, it is minus A. At time t is equal to 0, the particle is at plus A. So your time period is capital T. So that is time taken for one complete oscillation. So at time t is equal to 0, and now I am taking the particle is at plus A. So after t is equal to t by 4, so this is origin, this is plus A, this is minus A. Here time t is equal to t by 4, the particle is at origin, so the particle is moved towards negative x-axis. So at this origin, the particle have maximum velocity, that is called V maximum. At time t is equal to t by 2, the particle is at minus A. At t is equal to t by 2, the particle is at minus A. At t is equal to at t is equal to 3t by 4, particle is at origin, so it is moved towards right side direction. So at origin velocity is maximum. At t is equal to t, t is equal to capital T, so the particle is at plus A. If t is equal to t is equal to 5t by 4, the particle is at origin, so the particle moves towards the left side. So here velocity is maximum. Now I am taking the graph, displacement variable versus time. So here displacement is here maximum displacement is plus a minus a. Here time t is equal to 0. Here t is equal to t by 4. It is t by 2. Here it is 3t by 4. It is t. Here it is 5t by 4. At t is equal to 0, particle have plus a maximum displacement. Here it is at t is equal to 0, it have maximum displacement, that is plus a. At t is equal to t by 4, the particle is at mean position. Here t is equal to t by 4, particle is mean position. Here t is equal to t by 2, the position of the particle is at minus a. Here t is equal to t by 2, here minus a. Here t is equal to 3t by 2, the position of the particle is at origin. Here t is equal to 3t by 2, the position of the particle is at origin, equilibrium position. Here t is equal to 0, t is equal to, here t is equal to t, the particle is at plus a. Here t is equal to t, particle is at plus a. Here t is equal to 5t by 2, particle is at mean position. Here t is equal to 5t by 2, particle is at mean position. So now I am draw a graph. So it is like this. Here time period is here two simple harmonic motion may have same angular velocity omega and phase constant phi but different amplitude. So let us take two simple harmonic wave equation. So that is x1 of t is equal to a cos omega t plus pi, x2 of t is equal to b cos omega t plus pi. Here it is first equation, this one is second equation. Here both have same omega, same pi, but different amplitude. Here it is a, here it is b. So let us draw a curve x of t versus t. Here it is origin, this one is plus b, plus a, minus b, minus a. Here I am taking t is equal to 2 pi. So t is equal to 2 pi means what? So t by 4 is equal to how much? 2 pi by 4, that is equal to pi by 2. T by 2 is equal to how much? 2 pi by 2, that is called pi. 3t by 4 is equal to how much? 3 into 2 pi by 4, that is called 2 1s are 2 2s are, so 3 pi by 2, t is equal to 2 pi. 5t by 4 is equal to 5 into 2 pi by 4, 2 1s are 2 2s are, so that is called 5 pi by 2. So I am, here I am taking, if t is equal to 2 pi, small t becomes a angle. So here t is equal to 0, 0, t is equal to t by 4, that is equal to pi by 2, here it is pi by 2, here it is pi, it is 3 pi by 2, it is 2 pi, it is 5 pi by 2. If t is equal to 2 pi, t become an angle. So let us draw a curve. X1 of t is equal to a cos omega t plus pi. So here it is an angle, omega t plus pi. If t is equal to 0, that is omega t plus pi is equal to 0. Cos 0 is 1. 1 into a is a. If angle pi by 2, angle is pi by 2, that is called omega t plus pi, pi is equal to pi by 2. Cos pi by 2 is equal to 0. 0 into a, it is 0. Here, cos pi is equal to minus 1, minus 1 into a, minus a. Cos 3 pi by 2, it can be written as pi plus, so here pi plus pi by 2, cos pi plus pi by 2 is cos pi by 2, so cos pi by 2 is equal to 0, 0 into a, here it is 0. Cos 2 pi is equal to 1, 1 into a, here it is a. Cos 5 pi by 2, so here 5 pi by 2 is equal to, how we can write, 2 pi plus pi by 2, so cos 2 pi plus pi by 2, cos pi by 2, cos pi by 2 is equal to 0, 0 into a, 0, so here it is 0. So let us draw a curve. It is like this. So this is first curve. Let us see second curve. X2 of t is equal to b cos omega t plus pi. Here omega t plus pi is angle. So here I am taking angle. So if angle is 0, cos 0, 1, 1 into b, here it is b. Here angle is pi by 2, cos pi by 2 is 0, 0 into something, 0, so here it is 0. So if angle is pi, cos pi is equal to minus 1, minus 1 into b, minus b. Cos 3 pi by 2, 3 pi by 2 is written as pi plus pi by 2. So cos pi plus pi by 2, cos pi by 2, cos pi by 2 is 0, 0 into something, 0 into b is 0. Here cos 2 pi is equal to 1, 1 into b, here it is b. Cos 5 pi by 2, so here cos 5 pi by 2 is equal to 2 pi plus pi by 2, cos pi by 2, so cos pi by 2 is 0, 0 into b is 0. So let us draw a curve. It is like this. So these two curves have same omega and same phase but different amplitude. So here it is, first curve have amplitude A, second curve have amplitude B. So how to know it have same angular velocity, we know angular velocity omega, this has omega, this one also have omega. So what about time period? Time period t1 is equal, so 2 pi by omega. T2 is equal how much? It is also 2 pi by omega. So both curve have same time. Here both curve have same time period. So it have same time period. So here to here it is T. So from this, here angular frequency nu one is equal, how we can write? 1 by T1. So that is, it has same 1 by T. Nu 2 is equal 1 by T. So both curves have same angular frequency. So angular frequency is nothing but number of oscillations per second. So here number of oscillations in T time is, it is 1 oscillation. It is also a 1 oscillation. So both curve have same angular frequency. And how to know they have same phase? So here if we extend the curve along negative x axis, so here it is pi by 2, here it is minus pi by 2. If we extend this curve along negative x axis, the two curves start from at a point. So they all start at the same point. So the curve have same phase. So here these two curves have same frequency, same angular frequency and same phase, but different in amplitude. So this first curve have capital A amplitude, second curve have capital B amplitude. See, two simple harmonic motion may have same amplitude, so here it is A, and same angular frequency omega, but different phase constant. So let us take two equations. So that is x1 of t is equal A cos omega t, x2 of t is equal A cos omega t minus pi by 4. So let us take this one equation 1, this is equation 2. So here two simple harmonic motion have same amplitude, same angular frequency, but different in phase constant. Here it is phase constant is 0, here it is phase constant is minus pi by 4. Let us draw a graph. X of t versus t. Here I am taking time period t is equal 2 pi. For time period t is equal 2 pi. So here it is 0. Angles becomes, so here I am taking pi by 4, pi by 2, 3 pi by 4, pi, 5 pi by 4, 3 pi by 2, 7 pi by 4, 2 pi, 9 pi by 4, here it is 5 pi by 2. Here amplitudes are capital A to minus A. So let us draw a curve. Here x1 of t is equal, so here omega t is equal 0. Cos 0 is 1. 1 into A is A. Here it is A. Here omega is equal to pi by 2. Cos pi by 2 is 0. 0 into A, it is 0. Here omega t is equal to pi. Cos pi is equal to minus 1. Minus 1 into A, here it is minus A. Here cos 3 pi by 2. Here cos 3 pi by 2 is written as pi plus pi by 2. So that is cos pi by 2. Cos pi by 2 is 0. 0 into A, here 0. Cos 2 pi is 1. 1 into A, here A. Cos 5 pi by 2. 5 pi by 2 is written as 2 pi plus pi by 2. So that is cos pi by 2. Cos pi by 2 is 0. 0 into A is 0. So let us draw a curve. It is like this. So here, this one is first curve. See the second one. Here, omega t is zero. Omega t is zero means what? 0 minus pi by 4. Cos minus pi by 4. Cos minus pi by 4 is cos pi by 4. Cos pi by 4 is how much? It is 1 by root 2. So that is a by root 2. So it has some value. So that is this one. Next, here omega t is equal to pi by 4. Pi by 4 minus pi by 4. So that is 0. Cos 0, 1. 1 into A. It is A. So at pi by 4, second curve have maximum displacement. That is A. Here omega t is equal to 3 by 4. 3 by 4 minus pi by 4. That is 2 pi by 4. That is called 2, 2 1 is the 2, 2 is the. So here pi by 2. Cos pi by 2 is 0. 0 into A, here it is 0. So here for cos 3 pi by 4. 3 by omega t is 3 pi by 4. So x2 of t value is 0. Let us see. If omega t is equal to 5 pi by 4. 5 pi by 4 minus 5 by 4. So that is 4 pi by 4. So 4, 4 cancel. It is cos pi. Cos pi is equal to minus 1. Minus 1 into A, minus A. So for 5 pi by 4, it is minus A. See, here next one is 7 pi by 4. If omega t is 7 pi by 4, 7 pi by 4 minus pi by 4. It is 6 pi by 4. So, 2, 3 is the 2, 2 is the 3 pi by 2. So, 3 pi by 2 means what? It is pi plus pi by 2. Cos pi by 2. Cos pi by 2 is 0. 0 into A, here it is 0. See, 9 pi by 4. 9 pi by 4 minus pi by 4. That is 8 pi by 4. 4 ones are 4 twos are. It is 2 pi. So here cos 2 pi. Cos 2 pi is equal to 1. 1 into A. Here it is A. So here omega t is 9 pi by 4. X2 of t is A. Here it is A. So if theta is, see here, 11 pi by 4. If theta is 11 pi by 4. 11 pi by 4 minus pi by 4. It is 10 pi by 4. So 2 5 is the 2 2 is the. It is 5 pi by 2. So cos pi by 2 is equal to 2 pi plus pi by 2. So here it is cos pi by 2. Cos pi by 2 is 0. 0 into a is 0. So here it is 0. So let us draw a curve. This is second curve. So in this curve, both have same amplitude. So the maximum displacement of curve is here it is A, here it is A. So both have same amplitude and both have same angular frequency. Means what? The time period is time taken for one oscillation. So here to here and here to here. So both have same angular frequency. Here, how to know these two curves have phase difference? So let us extend the curve along negative x-axis. So here curves 1 is start first and curve 2 is start second. So there is a phase difference. How much it have phase difference? So here it is pi. Here curve 1 is lead, then curve 2. By angle pi by 4 or curve 2 log. Then curve 1 by how much angle? That is pi by 4. So here the difference between two curve is pi by 4. Finally, these two curve have same amplitude and same angular frequency but different in phase constant. Two simple harmonic motion may have same amplitude A and same phase constant pi but different angular frequency omega. Let us take x1 of t is equal A cos omega t plus pi, x2 of t is equal A cos 2 omega t plus pi. So it is equation 1, it is equation 2. So in this equation, both have same amplitude, same phase constant, but different in angular frequency. Here it is omega, here it is 2 omega. So from this, so T1 can be written as 2 pi by omega. T2 is 2 pi by 2 omega. So that is called 1 by 2 into 2 pi by omega. So that is called T1 by omega, T1 by 2. So here time period of second curve is half of the time period of first curve. So from this, how we can write frequency? Nu 1 is equal 1 by T1, nu 2 is equal how much? It is 1 by T2, T2 is equal T1 by 2. So it is 2 by T1, so 2 into 1 by T1. So frequency of second curve is 2 times of frequency of first curve. So that is called 2 into nu 1. Let us draw a curve. So it is T, here it is x of T, it is plus A, here it is minus A. Here it is origin. So here pi by 2, pi, 3 pi by 2, 2 pi, 5 pi by 2. So draw the curve for first equation. So here cos 0 is 1. So that is A. Cos pi by 2 is 0. Cos pi is minus 1, that is minus A. Cos 3 by pi to 0. Cos 2 pi is 1. Cos 3 by pi 2 is 0. So So here the time period of this curve is how much? It is t. So here to here, that is t. So the frequency is number of oscillations in a second in a t time is it is 1. Let us draw a curve for 2. So it is like this. So here time period for second curve, so this is second curve, this one is first curve. Time period for second curve is so here to here, so that is t by 2. So number of oscillations in t time is how much? It is 1 2. So here this two curve have same amplitude. So it has same amplitude, so they start from same point. So they have same phase constant and same amplitude, but different in angular frequency.